are part of the wider community of Holy Cross, and this being the district of Indiana province, then we also have programs that are connected directly to Indiana, especially Notre Dame. So what Notre Dame does, send us some of the students to come and have some experiences here.
And I have been overwhelmed everywhere I go at the hospitality and the love of the Christians as I travel around.
From our very beginnings in Peru, Holy Cross has been committed to the struggle for social justice. And the church is one of the places where people learn about their own dignity, and they can join forces with others in order to defend that dignity.
I think one of the wonderful things about the Catholic Church is the fact that we are a church that is present around the world, and that what happens in one part of the church affects and depends upon what happens in another part of the world.
Our hope is to free the women of this country and to give the women the confidence they can stand up straight and really know who they are.
These people are very simple. They live a very simple life, and they live in harmony with their neighboring groups of other religion denominations, like Baptists, Muslims and Hindus are also their neighbors. We have about 100 catechist teachers, we call them. They teach in the schools, at the same time they take care of the Sunday services on Sundays. They are the real ministry actually in the villages. They stay in the village, they take care of the people.
Notre Dame is celebrating its 50th anniversary. And the thing that is so important for us is that when we look at the mission of this school, we look at the dedication of Holy Cross at this school, we look at the dedication of the colleagues, our lay colleagues who are Holy Cross educators here at Notre Dame.
Our congregation of Holy Cross took on this mission in Mexico in 1987 here in Monterey. Our Holy Cross team is working to empower the laity and try to extend the reach of the church. But people come from the country by the hundreds and thousands into Monterey to find work, because rural Mexico is very, very poor. And so it's a battle to try to find these people places to live, and then other people come right away and take their place.
Trying to put together a community of people that recognize the dignity of each person as a creature of God, as a child of God, and as an image of God. We welcome everybody here. We believe that we all have that same status in light of our faith. We look at the way that Jesus welcomed all people, and that provides for us the cues that we need to say, if we want to create a Christian community, it has to be a community of inclusion in which we welcome all people.
There are yet creative ways to see the truth that Father Moreau always preached, namely, providence is at work. Providence guides Holy Cross, and providence would have much use yet for Holy Cross wherever we are. I think that's fundamental to our faith as Holy Cross religious.
As you know, formation in the novitiate is an important element in the community.
It's a time where we can really work with candidates or with novices without them being away at another school and the energy and time away from here that takes. And it's an important time to incorporate them into the traditions, habits, spirituality of Holy Cross, as well as trying to develop some deeper habits of prayer and spirituality in them. Our philosophy here now is to really focus on their relationship with God initially, believing that if we can really help them deepen their intimacy with God, that everything else will kind of follow. That we can teach them anything we want, but if they don't have a deepening relationship with God, it will go in one ear and out the other, or it'll last for a time. But if we can help them during this year to get in touch with God in a more personal and intimate way in their life, they have something solid to build on.